today we are here now at the hyperspectral, let's say, session called like this. And it's a collaboration between Vision and the EPIC, the European Photonics Industry Consortium that I represent here. I am laser expert for EPIC, and I'm really pleased to moderate this session today. And it's a particular pleasure, actually, to start this session with even my colleague, Peter Schwieder, the CTO from Photon Focus. So we are collaborating in this European-funded initiative, Multiple. And it's really nice to have Peter here today talking about this in specific and called Multimodal Monitoring Solutions for Industrial Applications. So thanks a lot. Peter, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Francesca, for the introduction. Hello. I want to give you an overview about the so-called Multiple project. It's a project where we build up in a big project a multimodal monitoring system for industrial applications. And I want to introduce you the project targets. And the idea is to make a system based on several sensors and build up a multimodal, cost-effective monitor solution and to make or to show in this spectral-based applications really a breakthrough in for the production process. So one of the main targets of this project are three use cases. I will speak later about this. So for the implementation of this multimodal monitoring system, there will be used some cutting edge organic electronic sensors, spectral sensors. The well-known hyperspectral imaging sensors. I will go in detail in the end of the presentation and will give more information about this. And also some very nice new laser spectrometers for the visible near range in the midwave range. And the backup, the data are really collected on edge computers. The data pre-processing and collection of the data is done locally. And the data are fed through a cloud, which allows with deep learning, big data analysis, making new models to optimize the production process and to give guidelines for the optimization of the processes. In detail, it looks like shown in this schematic here. On the base is real-time control, the factory floor with all the sensors. Visible sphere sensors, mid-infrared sensors, and based on this, the multimodal monitoring is done with the help of edge computing, and the information are fed through the cloud, which helps to develop fast models. And to give also data services based on the big data. An overview about the sensors which are used. There are laser-based infrared gas analyzers, snapshot cameras based on visible and sphere hyperspectral imaging sensors. Then some state or cutting edge electronic based spectrometers and two software technologies are combined. One is cloud and edge computing platform and services, and based on top of all this This is a complete monitoring system. It's a large consortium, many partners spread over Europe. I want to highlight three use cases which are important for this project. There's one project in the steel mill. This is an LDL together with Russula as system integrator. Then is a big use case in furniture production. This is done in, by Royo and SCM. And the third use case is chocolate production, which is done with the company Yutis in Greece. The other partners are the spectrometer developers, Epic and Thematis as marketing and supporting units, and Iman, Abraya, etc. They are used to set up the monitoring system. The three use cases are chosen with intention to demonstrate the strengths of hyperspectral imaging and spectroscopy in production. And we have now, since 5 years, hyperspectral imaging solutions in the market, and often we are confronted with the question to really show working use cases in the industry. And so we are really happy that we have now the chance within this project to demonstrate the power of hyperspectral imaging and multimodal imaging systems in production environments. And the three use cases are really completely different, and I will go to the details. So they are chosen in a conscious manner, and I think after the project we will have very nice use cases and more information how to set up multispectral systems in production environments. The first use case I want to go in details is the steel manufacturing. The target is here to optimize the furnace combustion. The steel slabs are reheated, and the process of heating the slabs could be optimized for sure to save energy and to reach the optimal temperature. So the second point, control the furniture temperature, is not so easy as one could say or think in a simple way. And another very important parameter is the temperature of the steel slab itself. This is very important to reduce the waste of material and to optimize the quality of the steel product after the milling. How it's planned to solve this? With the help of hyperspectral imaging sensors, we want to build up a pyrometry sensor and to really monitor the slab temperature, not only on the point, also with spatial resolution. And this should help us then to make a real-time adjustment of the process parameters of the oven and the milling process. The other thing is monitoring of the furniture production. There are several interesting parameters of wood, like humidity, density, etc. And this should be first solved by inspection and collection of all the data from the raw material and the process parameters. So it's planned to build up a warehouse for the data to enable one size batches in the production. So it's mandatory now that in the furniture production, the process or the sales is driven by online retail channels, and to deliver just in time, it's mandatory to have a process knowledge to make one-size batches with a high quality and in high efficiency. The other thing is chocolate production. This is really demanding because this is a batch process. This is not a continuous process. Chocolate is processed in tank reactors, and so it's not so easy to measure online the parameters listed here, viscosity, sugar content, and size of the sugar crystals. And mainly the size of the sugar crystals determines the flavor of the chocolate and the quality of the chocolate. So it's really important to control this process in a way that you don't stir the chocolate too long to have too small crystal size and to get bad quality. So also here, the focus is on process control in real time. The complete setup is done in a way that classical standards, industry standards are used. You see this on the camera interfaces. There are Gigi Vision, USB 3 Vision, MIPI interfaces are used. On the left side, the standard field buses are used in the system, and for the communication of the data warehouse and the production system, the production service, UPC UA is used as the standard. Let me go in the details with hyperspectral imaging sensors. In the project, we use snapshot imager sensors, which are another approach compared to the well-known push-broom concept. With snapshot sensors, you can make hyperspectral images with one shot, and you have not to scan the objects. This could be a benefit. On the other side, you have not so much spectral information as in push-broom applications. So the cameras produced for this or developed for this project are based on the sensors of IMEC, which is one project partner. The sensors from IMEC in the visible and near-infrared region are well known. In this project, a third spectral range, the sphere range, is realized. This is a spectral behavior of the visible and near-infrared sensors, but here you have the brand new technique for sphere sensors, and the idea is to use this hyperspectral sphere sensors for the temperature measurement, but maybe later also for other sorting algorithms. Our rule as Photon Focus, we implement based on this hyperspectral sphere sensors a camera, which is a cooled sphere camera. The special thing here is that we add up a mechanical shutter, which allows calibration in field in the application. The digital sphere sensor is very fast, so we have equipped this camera with a 10 gigabit Ethernet connection and to synchronize with the production process. The camera is equipped with a very advanced shaft encoder interface to make the implementation in the application easy. How it looks like, with the snapshot sensor is shown here. On the left part you see a photo of the different textiles, and you see the wool and linen could be discriminated with the help of this snapshot sphere imager. Another camera we implement for this project is the combination of a visible and sphere image sensor in one camera. Also here we have two mechanical shutters for in-field calibrations. And also here the data are processed in the FPGA, merged together in a data stream and transferred over 10 gig E interface. The sphere sensor is cooled and the visible sensor is uncooled in this application. Okay, I want to close my presentation with again a list of the partners. You find us on the internet, you can mail us, and you find us also on LinkedIn and Twitter. All right, thank you.
Thanks a lot, Peter. So now it's time for questions. I know you're a bit shy, but you can do even with your code there scanning. But I start with to break the ice. So Peter, we are here, and you showed that what multiple can do, these three internal use cases. And also you were mentioning sorting could be an application. Where do you see the, let's say, second step? Once we are done with these early adopters, where do you see maybe the first, second field of application that is more suitable for multiple?
Yeah, one of the next steps will be for sure the temperature measurement. Mm-hmm. I think this has a big potential. Not only in steel production, there are also other fields, for instance, glass production or cement production, where you have furnaces. You have to determine the temperature of the furnaces, mm-hmm. but also the temperature of the goods. And this is really complicated from the physics. So I think with this new technologies, with this spectrometer technology, but also with the modeling of this deep learning algorithms, I think the first results we had looking really promising, and I think this will be one of the big steps in the future. And the other thing, I think simple sorting could be done also in the sphere range with this 3x3 or 4x4 sphere sensors. Very, very simple applications, but I think it could bring the, in general, the hyperspectral imaging more to industry.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Peter. So if you don't have questions, are you sure? We can tell you, and nevertheless, that if some questions come later, you can come to our booth. We have a multiple booth here in this hall at the E34. And also for a question on Photon Focus, of course, Peter is also here with the Photon Focus hall, stand in the 10th
in the
hall.
10th.
Number, I don't remember.
30.
30, good, very good.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot, Peter.
Thank you very
much. Thanks a lot, Osmar.